How to control the BEAMAGE camera through LabVIEW. Start the intro. Hey everyone, Kevin here from Gentec-EO, your esteemed partner for accuracy. Okay, today I want to show you how to use a BEAMAGE camera with the LabVIEW software. You will see that it's actually quite an easy process, but there are a few things to keep in mind about it. And by the way, if you don't use LabVIEW at all, this video may not be very useful for you. The first thing to note is that we do provide a LabVIEW example for BEAMAGE cameras, but to work properly, you have to run at the same time our own PC BEAMAGE software, which is a free software that we provide with BEAMAGE cameras. This is because we use what is called a named pipe to allow communication between PC BEAMAGE software and LabVIEW. And basically this means that all of the data crunching, the calculations, image processing, this is all done in PC BEAMAGE running in the background, and this already crunched data is sent to LabVIEW. But still, you can achieve with this LabVIEW example almost anything that you could already do in our own software, but because you're in LabVIEW, now you can automate the whole thing to your liking. So you know what, I'll go show you the rest on the PC. So by the way, I don't have LabVIEW on my personal PC because, you know, LabVIEW licenses. So I'm on the remote desktop with LabVIEW 2017 on it, if you wonder. And I have already downloaded the LabVIEW example from the Gentec-EO website. Now the first step is to open PC BEAMAGE actually, which is what you see. And because we have to activate the named pipe feature that I mentioned before. So to do that, open the software and no need to connect to the camera just yet. Instead, go here in Advanced, then click Pipeline, and then just press OK right here. Now I need to go back in the folder where the downloaded VIs are. And as you can see, there are a bunch of VIs. Each one of those VIs basically represents one function of the software with just a few exceptions. So if there's something you can do in the software, like saving an image in raw format, changing the measurement definition, reading the measurement itself, there's a VI for that. And if you open one of those VIs, like Control for Sigma right here, which sounds pretty cryptic, right? You can see that there's not much to see on the surface, but if you open the diagram view with Control E, you can see that it actually works through a system of commands. And you can see this is the command right here. It's *CTL4SIG. So basically you send a command to call upon a function of the software. And these comments are all listed in the BEAMAGE manual near the end of the manual. Now there's one VR in particular that shows how many of these functions can be used together. And it's this VI right here called PC BEAMAGE LabVIEW example. So let's open it. So basically this is just an example of how you could build your own control panel for the BEAMAGE camera. So you know, I can connect to the camera, I can start capture, I can do a background subtraction, I can change the beam definition or the position of the center. And if I open the diagram view for this VI, you can see how each function works. So you see these are all the functions. And if I don't know, click this one, oh well, this one is not a good example. This one, you can see what VI is used. And if you open the VI, you can see what command is used to do that. So yeah, you know what? Let's run the example instead of looking at the diagrams. So let me close that, just like that. And defer decision, I guess. So yeah, let's run the example. So just like that, make it full screen. I can connect to the camera like this. And if I press Start Capture, we can see in the software that it actually started capture. Before I switched to LabVIEW, you may have noticed I was not capturing. So you can see how those, you know, the LabVIEW example and the PC BEAMAGE software are currently linked together at this time. And again, while I'm here, I want to emphasize that you have to press that pipeline button for all of this to work. So yeah, now the rest really is up to you at this point to build your own LabVIEW program the way you want it. We hope this video helps. Don't hesitate to contact us if you have any questions. Merci beaucoup.